Now that you've got an idea of what's available on the library website, I'm going to show you how to search our databases. As you recall, before we went to Databases by Title to see the databases that are available. Then I mentioned that ProQuest Central would be the most helpful to you, so I'm going to click on that one. This is what the landing page for ProQuest Central looks like. From here, I can type in my search terms, and then I can see a bunch of results, and then I can filter them out depending on what I'm really looking for. I usually like to start broad with my searches, so let's try a search for natural remedies. At this point, I'm not going to make any other choices, not from this page. I will tell you a little bit about what you're seeing here, though. Where it says anywhere except full text, that means it's going to look through the title of the article, the title of the journal, the different subjects that the article covers, and also the abstract, which is like a short summary of the article. That's what I want. I don't want it to search the entire text of the article because that could bring me up a bunch of results that aren't actually that relevant. Down below, I can also make choices about what kind of a source I'm looking for or what language I'm looking for, but I can also make those same decisions later. So I'm just going to stick with natural remedies, anywhere except full text, and do my search. Now, I got 10,000 results. That's a lot. That's way more than I would ever want to look through. But we can start by limiting by looking on the left-hand side and seeing what some of our choices are. We've got scholarly journals, we've got books, we've got dissertations and theses, we've got newspapers, we've got magazines, and a bunch of other types of sources too. If I click on the more, like I just did, I'll see all the different types of sources that are out there. Now for this assignment, you need to either choose a popular source or a scholarly source. You need one of each. So I think let's focus first on the popular sources. So I actually don't want wire feeds, which are like press releases. For this particular choice, I don't want scholarly journals. We'll return and look at those later though. I think I might want magazines. Trade journals are going to be very specific to sort of business and industry, so I don't think I'm going to want those. I don't think I'm going to want reports. I don't think we want quite as informal as blogs, so I'm going to also kick that one out. Other sources, it is too vague. I don't think I want that. We definitely don't want dissertations because those are highly scholarly and very specific. And I think we can go ahead and exclude working papers, conference proceedings, and books as well. So for this one, we're just going to look at newspapers and magazines because those are the typical popular sources. Now I've gotten rid of a lot of my results. I'm down to 7,000. If I look on the left-hand side, I can also see that I've got other choices for limiting it. Here we've got a date range, and I can limit by date range. And so we might want to do that because going all the way back to 1980 might be just way, way, way too old. So we can slide this bar over and pick things that are much more recent. So let's do that. Now we've gotten rid of a lot more. We're down to a little over 2,000. That's still a lot, so I'd like to see some of the other options here. Remember that I said later on you could also choose language? Let's go ahead and choose language. Looks like they're mostly in English anyway. And something else that's interesting is you can also choose location. So I think because we're looking at the United States, I might want to limit it just to the United States. You might want to look at some of these other sources at another point later, but you can always remove your filter if you want to. So now we've got 105. That's a much more reasonable list. So I can start looking for articles that I think are going to be helpful to me. There's all different kinds of things out here that are about natural remedies. So here's one, No Fail Health Remedies from Good Housekeeping Magazine. That's definitely what we would call a popular source. It's not a scientific journal that's talking about scientific studies. It's really written for a popular audience. If I click on that article title, it'll bring me up the full record, so all the details that I might need. It's going to give me an abstract, which, like I said, was a summary of what's in the article. This one also is full text, which is nice. It makes it easier You've got the full text right there. You don't have to click anything else to get it. It also gives you all the publication information you need, the name of the magazine, Good Housekeeping, where it's published, New York, the date, September 2019. So this one's very recent, and also the pages where you find the article if you actually had that magazine in front of you. So this is one popular source you might want to look at. You notice a few other things. On the right-hand side of the screen, you've got related items. So these are other articles that the database is suggesting to you that might be interesting to you. You've got subjects you can search on if you want to click on one of those subjects and find other articles on those specific subjects. And then you've also got this Hannon Library logo. And if you click on that, that will take you back to our Hannon Library catalog to look for other articles. And you might want to do that if this was one that we didn't have in full text. We'll look more at cases like that another time. Now if you look at the top of your screen, you'll see that you can go back to your results. And we're going to do that to look at some of our other options at this point. Here we've got our list that we found before of all these different articles. We also can see on the left-hand side all the filters that we added so that we could get these results. Now, if I want to look at scholarly journals now, because I know you do need to find a scholarly journal article too, I can just clear all of my source types. And that's going to open it up to everything except for things that were before 2010, that were not about the United States, or that were not in English, because I kept those filters. I could get rid of those filters too if I wanted to, just by Xing them out. And you can see now we're back to our 10,000 results. So now let's start looking for those scholarly articles. Let's click on scholarly journals here. You can see there are 747 of those 10,000 that are in scholarly journals. So right away, it's going to drastically limit our results, which is good because we don't want to look through 10,000 things. Now we've got all kinds of articles that are in scholarly journals and they're about natural remedies, or at least somewhere in the abstract or the title or the subject are the terms natural remedies. So if we're seeing that there's a really big difference of kinds of articles, like here there's something about water, and then here there's something about blight resistance in rice, these are not necessarily about health remedies, we could then go over to the left-hand side where it says subject. And we could open that up with a little arrow and then do more. Now it's going to tell us in all those 747 scholarly articles, these are all the different subjects that the articles were about. So right away we've got herbal medicine. That might be one we want to include. Also, natural products maybe is one we want to include. There's all different kinds of things here. What we're not going to want to do are things like rodents, right? Because that's going to be something about, you know, rat tests or something like that. Or maybe not other things that seem to be about, you know, like the water or agriculture or things like that. So let's just stick right now with herbal medicine. Apply that and see what we get. Now we've got 146 scholarly journal articles that are about herbal medicine. They start at the top with the most recent ones, and down near the bottom they'll be the ones that are much older. So we can look at these articles and see if there's anything in here that we think would be a helpful article for us to look at. There's all different kinds of scholarly articles about natural remedies. So here's one from this Food Science and Nutrition journal that's about tamarind. If we click on that, we're going to get a scholarly article because this is a scholarly journal, Food Science and Nutrition, and it's going to be all about the health benefits of tamarind. This might be the kind of thing you want to look at if this is an interest of yours. If I go back to the results, I can continue to look. I could apply other limits like the date limit or the location limit or things like that. And I've got a whole range of options. I hope this has been a helpful introduction to how to find scholarly and popular articles in our databases. Please reach out to me if you have any questions at all.